Hello everyone, I'm Mr. Mocha Lover, and thank you for joining me here at the start of a new campaign in which we're playing as that Mojave chapter. Now they got a new focus tree as of Old World Blue 3.0. We're going to leave historical AI focuses on just because I want to be able to have a good little tussle with the Mojave territories, but custom game rules, pretty much default, everything's, I have no idea, actually I kind of have an idea what's going to happen just because we left it on historical AI, but the mod we're using is obviously Old World Blues. The Old World Blues Radio, Player Led Peace Conferences, Colored Events, as well as State Treasure Tool Mod. Now, we're playing the Mojave chapter right now just because in October, I ran a poll on my Discord server in which the Mojave chapter was selected as the nation we play as next, so here we are. It takes a little bit of while to load up into the game, unfortunately, because there's much more to load, such as Oklahoma, Texas, and an updated Colorado. And little parts of Louisiana, but we're here regardless. We start with a couple divisions. Ooh, a Black Mountain Knights, which we will use, and we will change these guys out. We have McNamara, Hardin, Santangelo, which I always forget how to say her name. I'm gonna make Nolan the leader for them, but let's do some research. 5 research slots. Let's take a quick look at the tech levels. We're pretty much good in everything. It's middle of the path for everything, except for naval vessels, which makes sense. And not advanced for special forces. Vehicles, robotics, actually a lot of stuff we're not advanced in. That's totally okay though. Totally okay. Let's go ahead and grab some of this, Ohm's Law, very good. Grab some of this, combat language. Industry, and just pretty much max out our industry right now because we're going to need to. We need a lot more output. And need to do our land auction eventually as well, but we'll get there. We shall get there. I'm just going to build some civilian factories because we can. I might build some land forts maybe eventually, maybe, maybe not. A lot of resources, which is kind of nice. And the Wasteland's last great mind. Why am I even talking to you? I have more important things to do than explaining my plans to an imbecile. Or imbecile. Very cool. Nope, and let's let time go on. And you guys shall be led by Hardin. Cool. Very nice, and we have the Mojave territories here, and Captain 3.0 update. If you would like to read about this, I'm kind of getting more and more used to the Caps update for 3.0, so if you'd like to go right ahead, but we're just going to move on. And we got one whole cap. So the Wasteland's last great mind, a scribe of the Brotherhood of Steel, Elijah defied convention and rose to the rank of Elder, an honor usually reserved exclusively for paladins. An exception was granted for him on the grounds of him being a genius able to figure out what the workings of a device just by looking at it. His scientific acumen was matched only by his drive to recover and develop technology. His approach towards technology, iterating and improving rather than simply preserving it, was considered unorthodox by his peers. Elijah often dispatched scribes on tech retrieval missions, chasing all the leads he found. His drive to develop new technologies put him at odds with the more conservative members of the Brotherhood, particularly other elders. Presper is nothing in comparison to me. The Brotherhood is doomed without me. Only I can save the Wasteland. Actually, 5%, 5%, 8%, 8%. I want to get a lot more stability, but 5%, I mean, these are 8%. I'm going to go with the Brotherhood is doomed without me. And a journey to the Mojave. The elders at Lost Hills probably thought that this assignment was my banishment, a way to keep me from corrupting their ideals. Little did they know that this is what, in the end, I've always wanted. Very good. The Mojave conflict. So, eventually, let's see, the victor of the struggle between the Mojave conflict between us and them will occur with Operation Sunburst. We basically need to be prepared for the clash rather than pure strength alone. The more prepared you are, the stronger your forces will fight and the weaker your opponents. So Journey to the Mojave, a pathological control freak. He would often view the people under him as mere equipment, expecting them to carry out his orders and requests unquestionably, while dissent or unpredictability on their part would not just annoy but even outright infuriate him. By far, the only person with whom he had any kind of working relationship was scribe Veronica Santangelo, his pupil. The conflicts Elijah had with other members of the Brotherhood only worsened as Elijah pushed for developing new technologies, new technologies and new, ethically questionable weapons. The elders, rather than deal with him, decided to send him and a small accompanying Brotherhood force away out east to investigate the Hoover Dam and possibly bringing it back to functionality. Ultimately, I care for Veronica, or Veronica listens to me. That's why I respect her. I want more attack. I want her to be very violent, like children playing with bombs. It would have been a perfect assignment, a playground of free war wonders for me to plunder and claim for my own ends. There's only one thing keeping me from what I deserve, and its name is the NCR. Oh, let's go ahead and disable the backstory decisions, because we can do that for now. So let's talk about national spirits while we're waiting for this. So we have the Bunker Blues, which is okay. It's kind of nice. Less damage to garrisons if you own La Resistance. This idea also adds 2 counterintelligence and 1 crypto strength. But we'll talk about the other one very soon. Children playing with bombs. When Elijah and his newly formed Mojave chapter arrived, they were too late. Just 1 year prior, the NCR, a republic of whom the Brotherhood has been fighting for over 100 years, has claimed it for themselves. Elijah was furious, liking it to children playing with a bomb. With a dam under occupation, Elijah could do little else besides set up operation at his secondary objective, a power station known as Helios 1. There he would plan for the fall of Oliver and reclamation of the dam. I won't let anyone take what is owed to me. The Brotherhood would not be slighted. And I don't want to forget. I forgot about doing this. We're going to need more divisions where we're going, so. But we don't need an extreme amount when we're going to go to war, so. Cool. I don't want to forget that. I really don't want to forget that. Cool. So, civilian and... let's look at this. Construction. Production. Now, this is nice and all. We're going to get a lot more power armor, though. And eventually, we don't need pioneer kits. Can't believe I forgot this earlier on. We're going to put anti-tank rifles right underneath that because our infantry actually already have them. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Good. Because if you look at this, night patrols are only 6 combat width and have anti-tank. Paladin patrols, 10 combat width with anti-tank as well. So, I'm going to go ahead. I normally like getting more civilian factories, but the Brotherhood will not be slighted. I'm going to go with them just because we can produce things a little bit faster. Actually, you know what? I'm not going to touch that. Let's make sure we get some anti-tank as well. That'll be important. So, here's the deal. Because the war is going to happen soon, we could go down this way, in which we can get civilian factories, lots of civilian factories, actually. Lots and lots and lots. And get more military factories. Or, we could just bypass those and do work with the gunrunners, get a few workshops, get a few civilian factories, and some energy and infantry equipment, instead of wasting time going through these 8 focuses instead of just doing 2, because we need to get through this quickly. So, we're going to do this one first. Work with the gunrunners. I respect the gunrunners more than the rest of the children merrily dancing around post-apocalyptia. Rather than just acting as scavengers shifting through the garbage, they actually take the effort to make their own weapons. It's something that Lost Souls would never do, but I could cut a deal with them to allow them to act as an arms supplier. Cool. In which we definitely want those factories, and actually we'll put 2, 1, 2... And we'll save that for later, probably, just because we don't really need it. We're going to get 1.13 political power every day. We should be 40 days away from research, so let's talk about this national spirit. Sorry, I have a cup of coffee here. It's pretty good. So, Operation Sunburst. We need to get more preparation so that we don't have debuffs. And I'm not exactly sure, but the Mojave territories, they have the same idea. They have a bonus. So, they get a bonus, so we have a debuff. So, if we have a buff, then they get a debuff. Actually, I don't know anything about these guys. Support from Treaty Sands. Pacification, not emancipation. Treaty of New Vegas, of course. And followers spreading. So we'll probably get the followers of the apocalypse very soon as well. Now, with our political power, I'm probably going to save it and immediately get... not Surveyor. I'm going to grab Paladin and Todd, which I think instantly of Paladin and Todd Howard. Or just Todd Howard. But anyways, just because you can improve your economy law, trade law, conscription law, improved relations cost, maintenance cost, which we don't really care about, and get 10% more political power, just because I want political power as fast as possible. And it helps us later on when we do need to get to senior knights, as well as well-equipped army, which will shave just a little bit of political power off, which would be kind of nice. Construction basics, great. Let's go with work as needed, because we want to get as much output as possible right now. We're going to grab some wood working as well. Let's grab some improvised tools, and I'm going to go ahead and do the land auction so we get concentration of force. But come back over here, and let's begin doing reference manuals. That'll be good. Very, very good. We're about to get paid soon, too. You only get less than 10 caps a quarter, but, you know, whatever. We've got a little bit more than a year until the war starts between us, which is totally fine for me. I don't really care. Because we'll do well. We'll do well anyways. Hopefully. I think we will. Let's see, over here, let's go ahead and grab, since we're leading tanks and infantry, let's just get some more recovery rate. Let's just do that one. Seems pretty nice, and we don't need to train anybody just yet. Stonks, we aren't quite sure what an index fund is, or even if they exist. Against advice from our esteemed advisor, Jeremy, this investment has done great in growing the wealth of our nation. A free 150 caps, not bad. overclock Hidden Valley generators. I don't have time to be doing that renovation work. For the purposes of energy core recharging, we can just use energy stockpiles located at Hidden Valley. Nice, look at that. 1, 2, 3. At least I'm gonna keep one on here. We need more water, which I'm kind of hoping that we get the followers of the apocalypse soon, just so that we can get more water using one of their decisions. So, there we go. Don't want to waste any time with this. Now we get 1.34. So basically, we've got 0.2 more political power every day. And that shaved it up by 10, which isn't a whole lot, but that's fine. And see, I shaved this down by 15. That's not bad. We have no outsiders as well. Outsider initiates. We get plus 50% non-core manpower, which isn't bad. Outsider knights, which you get another 50% non-core manpower. So, not bad. Reference manuals. Let's grab some secret language. So I'm not really sure what the scope of the campaign is going to be for the Mojave chapter. We'll get through the focus tree, of course, but look at this. For 270 days, we get more non-core manpower, but weekly manpower plus 15. Construction speed, meh, that's not really going to help us. High chief, army chief, economy law, conscript stuff. That might be worth doing. I think we might do this. Even 15 more... 15. Well, let's do some math here if we can. 270. Weekly manpower plus 15. So 270 divided by 7 is about 38 weeks. So 30... Well, it's really more like 38 and a half. So 38 times 15 results in about 570 manpower. That's actually not too bad. Could we use another 570 manpower? Probably. You know what? Let's do it. We're going to get less gas, but I don't really care, to be honest with you. That'd be fine. Very fine. Very fine. No, actually, 570. Roughly 570 is not bad. So, the next thing we do with political power is we're going to get the Army XP dude. Scribe Schuler. So, for refined warfare research speed. And we could do Sedwick, but he's only 10%. Francis Johnston, 3% more research speed. Walton Fry. I almost never choose stuff to get more air doctrine or naval doctrine XP. Or just, you know, research bonus. 4 more days, anything here? Nope. Which is fine with me. And we'll be testing the bear immediately. The NCL swarms like ants over old world relics. It's only a matter of time before they come after Helios to try to take what is mine. I need to break the NCR before they have that chance, and for that, I need a plan. Very good. Kaza's Legion is going to war the dancers? The ranchers. The Kibby dancers, minus 10%, still not great, but hey, more population is fine with us. Shield's army declared war on Cobbin. You know what? Let's grab some air stuff. Gliders will be important. Cool. And this is still 100, so, eh, whatever. That manpower is going to be very nice, even though, yeah, we definitely got to get this guy immediately, just because we got to edit our division templates, like I said earlier. Infantry is only 6 combat width. We got to give him at least 10 combat width, because 6 combat width, that's not very good. That's not very good, not going to lie. Come on, come on. Testing the bear. Awesome. Immediately grab that. Cool. Now we have a choice. We could do tender business, which that promotes Harden to a degree, I guess, suppose. Oh, well, you can bring up the impending launch of Operation Sunburst by 10 days. Wow. Van Graaff, supply runs, death and glory. Or we could do that lucky old son. Elijah gets obsessed elder instead of distressed elder. Poseidon Relic Energy, which is not bad. Assigning power. Petro Chico Military Encryption. Spiritual and Sun. Or we'll do I Could Make You Care, in which we talk about Veronica. Using Super Mutants. Ooh, get more manpower and stability. Work with the Bright, we get manpower and stability. Slay the Star Chasers, which get manpower and stability. And then Paladin of the Mojave. Much more manpower and much more stability. Ooh. So, I could make you care. Veronica was always the person I was closest to. It's why I had her come with me to the Mojave. I had to show her what could be accomplished, you know, if you know how to put the old world to use in the right ways. Now, though she has a strange plane she has brought to my attention, she feels as if I was to get the denizens of the Mojave on my side, victory against the NCR would be all but assured. which is probably a good thing. But trials and tribulations, or conflict with the Mojave territories, is inevitable. Soon enough, potential pressure from the NCR Congress will place overwhelming force on General Oliver to launch his assault on Helios 1. The only way we can ever hope to fend off their onslaught is through preparation of a unique dynamic modifier representing the struggle for initiative between the Brotherhood and the NCR. When Operation Sunburst occurs, the current balance of preparation will be set in stone, so we must make sure to be well prepared before the war ever comes. We must be prepared if... We must be nothing if not prepared. We need more men to counter the NCR's numbers. Or through power armor alone, we will win victory. I like that, but let's get more preparedness just in case. It hurts our stability. I'd hate losing stability so much. But I think that will probably help us out. So now, Operation Sunburst is at a standstill. So no benefits, but no penalties. And for these guys, they have no benefits and no penalties as well. Which is going to play to our advantage soon. And we can usually almost always get more stability in later on anyways. So we could raise our... What was it? Economic policy, economy law. You get down here, which wouldn't be bad. Country-based node income plus 20%. No, well, actually, if you mobilize more, you lose money. You lose more money, you get less money. Don't lose money, you get less money. What we're going to do next, I'm probably going to do one of these so we get more stability. We're probably going to do prioritize consumer technology. Look at that, we already have one army XP. Yes, please. Woodworking, very nice. Improvised tools, work as needed. I'm going to grab this one ahead. I don't care if it's ahead of time. I want more output right now. Let's see. Let's grab some organized agriculture. That'd be very bueno. And let's grab some warrior training. 227 manpower. Not bad, not bad. Yeah, we got to fix this. Because we lose political power and output. So we want to get at least 50%, even though... What do we... We get like... 1, 2, 3, so 15 plus 15 is... 15 times 2 is usually 30. So basically we'll end up with 30% more stability. It's not bad. I want more, though. It can hurt our research speed. That's fine, whatever. 6 days, we'll have some gliders. That's nice. So after this, we'll do using the super mutants. Near Black Mountain lives this group of super mutants that are particularly strange. If you want to read about the followers of the apocalypse, go right ahead. I'm just going to let them come. They'll only do good, so... We'll welcome them in. They're led by one calling themselves Tabitha, a super mutant who uses radio broadcasts to tell other mutants of our nation of Utopithia. According to Veronica, they could be easily swayed to join our side if we were to simply jam their broadcast and tell them that it's the NCR that is keeping their broadcast from playing. So we're going to lie to the state of Utopithia. Okay. Cool. A simple lie, that's all. That's all. Just a simple, simple lie. Let's go and grab motorized flight, because I will want to start building some planes soon-ish. There you go. We will need a lot more energy weapons as well. So, and see, now we're already lacking water, so that's why I wanted the followers of the apocalypse to come. And hopefully they don't ruin our war support, even though we do get more stability from them, which is kind of nice. Begin a scavenging program. We could do that, but we'll do that once the war with the Mojave territories is over. After that, I'm probably just going to manually go to war with Vault 3, the Fiends, because they have more resources, and we could core them. And then I might just provoke an early war against New Vegas, because we're going to need to take them out eventually. And if I can core New Vegas, that's so much more manpower. And obviously, with our nation, manpower is a little bit of an issue. Survivalist, life giver. That'd be good. Next up, oh, we only have 3 army XP, that's fine. So we got to make... Okay, so we have enough guns for now. Oh, we really want stonks. Again, okay, bull or maybe bear. Cool. How much longer are they going to take? 42 days. I'll probably also go with that weapons expert. Organized agriculture. Let's grab the next one, too. Seed selection. That'll be good. Great. Harden. Strong back, gunslinger. You're using infantry, which we might continue using. I'm not really sure. I'm not going to choose anything for him just yet. And rapid deployment. Breakthrough. Max speed. Beautiful. Another power armor division. Great. After this, though, I'm going to boost you up by one more. After you do that one. Using the super mutants. Work with the Bright. The Brotherhood of the Blight. Or Bright. As it is known, is a collection of ghouls that believe in space. There is a home out there that would be the perfect home for them. By using a Repcon rocket, they hope to travel there. They just need assistance. Veronica says that if we're promised to help them get the rocket operational, they would be willing to help us fight the NCR. Oh, Repcon, I remember that mission in New Vegas. Fun mission. Followers are established. 29 days, that's fine. Actually, that's actually what we really, really want. I might just go down here anyways right now. Not bad for manpower, not bad at all. Around here, Joseph, that's okay. Surveyor, we don't really need that right now. I might choose a little bit of lag. There we go. Knightly armaments, because we get more reliability for power armor, which I do like quite a bit, so. Oh, we have 5 army XP. We don't really have enough infantry equipment. You know what? I'm gonna slash you down by a little bit more for now. That didn't really help us at all. But we gotta improve our division templates. I'm gonna duplicate these guys first. 20s. And then night patrols, you're gonna be hit first. Welcome aboard. Now all you guys can train. Now we're probably out of infantry equipment, which really sucks. Alright. 14 days. We could do this. I'm gonna save it up for the followers. Because they're slowly destroying our war support, but it's not that bad. Left goods, meh, it's not really worth it. Invest in small businesses, that's not really. Except 15% more output, actually. Could be pretty worth it right now. High command, chief army, economy laws. Actually, economy laws. Right now, it is 90. What if we did that? I haven't tried this one yet, so let's try this. 90 goes down to 68, that's not bad. 83. That's actually not bad to use. Bribes. 100, of course, here. 100 still here. Anything here? 100. Okay, well, you know what? Since we got it, just do this anyways. I love money. I love money. 2 days left. And coffee, too. If you'd like to read about this, this happens in pretty much every campaign. Go ahead. Awesome. And actually, since they're here, always help settlements. Always, always, always. Yes. And then we'll get some agricultural experts. We get more monthly population, which is okay. It's not great. But we also get a civilian factory out of that. I couldn't think for a second there. Yes. Get more water. 6 more water in Black Mountain. Yes, please. And then sway the Star Chasers. Out there in the wasteland are a group known as Star Chasers. Unorganized but experienced wastelanders trying to find Sunset Sarsaparilla Star Bottle Captain and an old world treasure connected to them. Veronica has a plan in mind. If we were to simply spread the rumor that the NCR is here to hunt the Caps, they would join our side. And now we have this, which hurt our war support, but did give us some more stability, which is kind of nice. And the Matrons were puppeted, huh? Ooh, we did lose political power. Ooh. We got 10% more research speed, which is kind of nice. Hey, look, plus 10 operational preparation? Yes, please, for us. Yes, 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 yes. Alright, we could grab that. Let's see. Industry. We're doing really well on industry, actually. I'm going to grab some resistors first so we get more research speed. Let's see. How much longer? We got 157 days. Not bad. Not bad if I do say so myself. Political bribes. I like that one. Can only get 1.31 political power every day because of the followers' influence. Oh, terrible. And we're about 3/4 of the way through the military signing bonuses, which is fine. Alright, so we got 2 more army XP. You guys are still training. We could train these guys. I want to really make 20 combat with divisions. But hold on, we will get some more army XP somewhere here, right? Ooh, somewhere. If we do this one, we don't get it, but we do simulation training, then yes. I'm going to grab Paladins of the Mojave first, just because we get more stability that way. And then, we're going to grab simulation training. Ooh, stability. Stability now. Aggressive policy for 365 days. Yeah, let's do the Paladins of the Mojave first, because within a year we'll be at war anyways, and we will need as much attack as possible. Slave Callers, we might as well. They're so good. I love Slave Callers. Yeah, within a year. Good. Could grab some of this stuff. Oh, but we do this too. Research speed. Oh, bonus for medical technology is not bad. Can't do anything else here. I might just grab Security Expert. Ooh. Oh, wait, the NCR declared war on Umbra. Yeah, it used to be that the Washington. Western Brotherhood Seal would do that. Max Entrenchment. That's not bad. Ramos, we want more attack and planning. Sway the Star Chasers, though. Paladins of the Mojave. Veronica has been taking my advice to heart, it seems, but in her own way. She understands that people can be pushed and used to accomplish your goals if you just merely give them a little incentive, yet still wishes to try for results that may lead to everyone's betterment, rather than just herself. She still has some ways to go, but I like her progress so far. Awesome. 51% stability, not bad. And we've got quite a few days for this, which is awesome. Military High Command. Yeah, since we have the political power, we might as well use it now to get someone else. It's 0.06 years ahead of time. There's not really much we can do here with this stuff yet. We already have anti-tank, which is, I think, awesome. Just straight up awesome. Let's grab some automation, just so we can get some cap. Local workspaces. Great, great, great. 0.05. Let's grab some multi-purpose equipment, just because it's quick, it's 30 days, and by the time we're done with it, we'll be in 2276, which will be a new year, which will be great. More attack. I like the reliability, though. I really do. And it helps us with research speed, even though we can't really research more stuff right now. 105, that's not bad. But we have to be at war, probably. Maybe not, actually. Yeah, we don't actually have to be at war. If we do that, we do get less attack, but barely any less attack. Ooh. 5% more attack. Let's see. Sato? We're going to go veteran paladin. 10% more attack is just... I've got to get that. And then we'll grab some more stability. Ruthless Draws, I don't think I've ever seen that to be really worth it. Maybe if you're, like, really not doing well, but... Hey, look at that. That's really nice. Alright, so 5 more. Make these guys at minimum 10 combat width. Minimum. Everyone keep training. They still have some XP, so they don't really need to train. This group does, which is totally fine with me. 1.35, not bad. And in 3 months, we will be at war. Very good. There's a ranger to go on jackals. Hey, and see, happy 2276, my friends. Happy New Year. Let's go and grab some of this. Smoke signals. Better reinforce rate. How's their preparedness like? Plus 10%. That's what we like to see. Paladins of the Mojave. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful, my friends. Now, we can't do this stuff until we're at war, which is fine with me. You don't get that many benefits from it anyways. So, let's go and do simulation training. I always hated VR training. Sitting in a chair while a computer gives you delusions is no way to learn how the world really works. How it ticks and bends your actions at the slightest touch. Still, some of our expedition is so inexperienced that a few rounds in the simulation ring might get them better ready for war. Hopefully, we can end this episode by going to war, because we have only 8 days left. I would like to see that. I really would. So, begin a scavenging program. Go and do that. That's fine. 78 days left. We only get 5 that... We're only halfway through the political bribes. Ooh, I want more stability, like I said, but we have political bribes. I love political bribes. Slave collars? Ugh, don't mind if we do. Over here. Yeah, we're gonna get planes. We might as well go for biplanes immediately then. We're not even making any yet. Yes, please. Yes, please. We're gonna need way more guns where we're going. Oof. They have a lot of divisions stacked on the border, but as long as we are a little bit more prepared than they are... Oh, 20%. Nice. Not bad. Not bad if I do say so myself. Let's grab some more construction speed. Now let's get some more cap and output first. Yeah. Cool. I'll soon have more army XP. That takes 60 days. God dang. Jesus. I want to make my guys 20 combo with before the war started, but, you know, maybe not. We do have 7 divisions here, so that's not too bad. 1, 2. Not bad. Vault City declare war on Pale Folk. We're out of infantry equipment, which we might be a little concerned about. I'm not going to lower this at all, so that'll be fine. Focus a little bit more on that stuff for now. Another division. Don't mind if we do. Go ahead and train a little bit more. Cool. Invest in small businesses. 50 days. 50 days. Not bad. Technology aid. How many more days we got with this? 47 days. And ooh, rapid deployment. Don't mind if we do. Now, I'm not really sure. Flexibility command is not bad. Non-combat supporting units. And then recovery and plus 10% reinforce rate. Or flexibility movement, which you get 10% more breakthrough and more max speed. Probably gonna go with flexibility movement because I love breakthrough. I love it so much. Love it, love it, love it, love it, love it. She has army. I did say I want more stability, but oh my goodness. If we get this right now, reconnaissance, recovery rate, 5% more attack, minus 10% supply consumption. That's so good. Ooh. Ooh, I'm tempted. I don't like being tempted like this. Oh, I'm just gonna do it. I know what I said earlier, but if we have cheaper costs for now, that just means we can save and spend political power somewhere else on something else later. Nice. We still have 40 days for that, so Operation Sunburst will commence soon. Do we still have a 20% bonus? Yes, we do. Wow. And then it's another 10% division attack until 2277, which is really nice. Anything here? Nope. After this, then we shall do power armor blueprints. When I arrived here from Lost Hills, my detachment was hardly equipped to deal with the threats we would face. I imagine not even Lost Hills would have predicted that the NCR would have arrived before us. I need to see if I can write up some improvements to the old power armor blueprints, find ways to make some more use of the stock we brought over, in which McNamara gets one more logistics skill, and we get a research bonus for power armor technology, which is not bad. Let's see, down here. You know what? By the time the next video comes out, or the next episode, we will probably be victorious here. So, I want to ask you guys now, should we establish Helios Citadel, in which it's renamed, Helios 1 is renamed Helios Citadel? Do we do the Neck of the Colorado, in which we get more electricity and change our capital to Hoover Dam? Or should we fortify Hidden Valley and we get more arms workshops, move the capital to Hidden Valley, so massively fortify the state? Peace Conference, cool. I want to know your thoughts below. Should we do this one, this focus, or that focus? In addition, should we render the Mojave dry? We get more research speed. Actually, no. Focus, tend to your business. Oh, wait, maybe we can't do that one. Tend to your business. Oh, we can't do that one, so we basically are probably forced to do mandatory service for all. No, we can't do that one either. Okay, so I just want to know exactly what we're doing. Rumors of the Sierra Madre. Oh, every attack. Rumors of the Sierra Madre. Every attack. I think I like that one more. So, regardless. Which one? Helios Citadel, Neck of the Colorado, which I kind of like. And Fortify Hidden Valley. Let's go and stop training for now. We got the Army XP. How many more days do we have? Oh, we have zero. Literally 0 days. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. I'm going to make these guys 20 combat with. Boom. Love it. And you guys, looking not bad. I'm going to convert you to 220 comp with Spec Ops Divisions. We're not going to have enough material for that, but whatever. Automation, very cool. And that's a little bit ahead of time, industry-wise. Grab some of this. Clayworking. And we have gone to war with these guys. Actually, can they come in here? That might not be good. But regardless, we shall end the episode here and begin and finish the war in the next episode. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's episode, guys. If you did, consider leaving a like. Subscribe if you're new. Check out my Discord link in the description below, and I'll see you tomorrow when we will destroy the Mojave territories and have a good time doing so. Thanks for watching, but have a great rest of your day.